Hello children, hope you're all fine. Today we are going to see poem 5, Where Do All the Teachers Go by Peter Dickson. Peter Dickson is a poet, performer, educationalist and artist. He grew up in London. Peter became a school teacher and senior university lecturer. He has published several poetry collections for children. Where do all the teachers go? Where do all the teachers go when it's 4 o'clock? Do they live in houses and do they wash their socks? The child wonders and questions where all the teachers go after the school has when it is 4 o'clock. He wants to know if, like any other ordinary being, they also live in houses and wash their socks. Means, do they also do all the routine work like other people? Do they wear pyjamas? And do they watch TV? And do they pick their noses the same as you and me? The child wants to know if teachers also wear clothes like pyjamas and watch TV like them. Do they also clean their noses the way other people do and waste their time? Do they live with other people? Have they mums and dads? And were they ever children? And were they ever bad? Further, the child wonders by asking if they are also surrounded by people, if they also have parents and children like us to live with. Did they commit any mistakes or did anything wrong when they were children? Did they ever never spell right? Did they ever make mistakes? Were they punished in the corner if they pinched the chocolate flakes? Now he wants to know if they also made mistakes or were ever punished for stealing chocolates or doing any silly or naughty. Did they ever lose their hymn books? Did they ever leave their brains? Did they scribble on the desktops? Scribbling means draw or write something that is not readable. So, hymn books means religious books. The tender mind is also bothered to know if the teachers also ever lost their religious books and said no to green vegetables. Did they also waste time by scribbling on tables? Did they wear old dirty jeans and wear torn and old jeans? I'll follow one back home today. I'll find out what they do. Then I'll put it in a poem that they can read to you. To overcome his curiosity, the child decides to follow his teacher on his way home after school. Once he is clear about everything, he would also like to compose or write a poem about it and thinks that the teacher would read the poem to his students. That's all, children. Thank you.